Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over 7 different tips and tricks for using Microsoft Sway. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. So to start, I have gone to office.com, and I'm going to go down here to Apps, and I'm going to pick the icon right here that says Sway. Once I'm inside of Sway, I'm going to go to Create New. So let's call this Sway, Tips and Tricks for Sway. And let's make a presentation about Microsoft Excel. So the first tip is to click right here where it says Background, and you can search for images online. So I'm going to type in Excel and click the search button. Now I'd like you to look right here where this checkbox is checked. This is for Creative Commons only. So these are images where you don't really have to worry about copyright as long as you're using them for non-commercial purposes. So I'm going to scroll down and click this image for Excel. And I'm going to say Add. For our second tip, I'm going to show you how you can use focus points. So I'm going to click in this gray space and then click this plus button right here. And I'm going to insert another image. So let's say I scroll down and pick the Excel icon right here and click Add. If I click on focus points, I can see what this is going to look like on a website versus what this is going to look like on a mobile phone. So I can check that the entire image is important, and you can see that Excel has moved to the left of the website. Or I can uncheck that box, and you can see that the Excel logo is being stretched out right here when on a website. And I can see that it's a little bit bigger right here on the phone. But now I have a few options when the icon comes up on the screen. I can either zoom in to the icon itself. So let's say I click on the image here and here. I'm going to play the slideshow so you can see how this is a zoomed in view of the image that you have up here. So if I go to the Excel icon slide, you can see that we've really zoomed into the image. If I go back and I hit focus points and I hit reset and I click here and here, and then I play my slideshow, you can see that I've now zoomed out on my image because I wanted to focus more on the borders. So the third tip I have for you today is I'm going to go to a new card and insert another image card. And this time I'm going to insert a group of images from my computer. So if I go up here to the down arrow and I go down to my device, so I'm going to select all of these and number 7 and hit open. Because I opened all of my images at the same time, you can see that these images are grouped. So if I click on the group button, I have some options for grouping my images. The first one is a stack. So I'm going to select that one and I'm going to play the slideshow so you can see what that looks like. So this is a stack. If I hover over, I can click through each of the icons until I get to the end. So I can sort of see the progression of the Microsoft Excel logo changing. If I go back up here to group type, I can change that to a grid. And so if I play that one, you can see that I have all the logos right next to each other in a grid format. And if I go back and hit group type again, I can also hit slideshow and play my slideshow. And you can see that those logos are now on the screen and I can just click through those like a regular slideshow. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. The fourth tip is an image comparison. You can think of this as like a before and after picture. So if I click here and I add an image, I'm going to go to my device and upload this image right here, which is a picture of what Excel looked like when it first came out. And I'm going to hit open. Next, I'm going to insert another image from my computer. And it's going to be a picture of what Excel looks like now. And I'm going to hit open. Now I'm going to create a group of images by selecting this image card and clicking and dragging up to the image card before it. And this will automatically create a group of images. So there are two ways to create a group of images. One is to just upload a bunch of images at the same time. And the second way is what I just showed you, to create a second image card and drag that into the one above it. So if I scroll down here, I get an option for comparison. So I'm just going to click on the comparison right here. And if I hit play, the comparison is going to look like this on the screen. And this is really neat because I can click right here on these arrows and I can drag to the right and see what Excel looked like when it first came out. Or I can drag to the left and see what Excel looks like now. So it's a really good before and after shot. I'm going to click the plus and insert another card, but this time I'm going to go over to media and insert an embed card. And now I'm going to go over to Google Maps, where I have searched for the location of Microsoft Visitor Center and Company Store. And you can see the map is Microsoft's headquarters. So if I go up here to the Google menu to share or embed map, I can click this option here to embed a map, and then I can copy HTML. Now, I just want to tell you that I do need to go to embed instead of just send a link. So let's look at the differences between these two. If I go to send a link, it starts with HTTPS, but if I go to embed, it starts with iframe. So any embedding you're doing in an embed card inside of Sway needs to start with iframe. So I'm going to copy that and go back to Sway and paste that embed code right here. So let's see what that looks like in our presentation. So now you can see I have the map directly inside my presentation. And I can click on the map and I can drag just like I can in Google Maps. I can go over here and zoom out. And I can also zoom in. Next, let's insert another image. And this time I'm going to upload an image from my device. And I'm going to put in a GIF. So I'm going to select that and say open. And right here, it looks pretty static. And if I play my slideshow and scroll down, you can see that my GIF is moving just like a GIF should. And finally, what would an Excel presentation be without an actual Excel spreadsheet? So I'm going to click on here and insert an image card and go over here to suggested and go up to my OneDrive. And I'm going to grab my dashboard file and hit add. And now when I play my presentation, I can see my actual spreadsheet right here on the screen. And I can click through my tabs in Excel. I can also see a full-sized workbook that's been opened in Excel in office.com. And if I don't want to open up the whole workbook every time, I can close this and I can hit this button right here to refresh all data connections. So hopefully these 7 tips and tricks will help you create some impressive Sway presentations. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.